Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with a Steyr Waffelcock. What is this vehicle? This tank is pretty much ultimate bushwhacker, which do not have armor, which do not have speed, which have quite good gun and quite good camo. Speaking about the camo which we have on this vehicle now, it is 47. 47 is huge. Well, let's compare that with a Super Hellcat, and with a Super Hellcat we have camo of 42. So this vehicle is a bit more sneaky than a Super Hellcat, but if you want to be disappointed right there, this camo should be lower than E25 53, as you can see. So it's somewhere. As a tank destroyer, as a bushwhacker, it's completely fine as a tank, right? What can I say more about this tank? No armor, quite good at hiding in the bushes and shooting enemy tanks. Pretty much this is a full review of this vehicle. And if you are wondering why we are having this tank in action now, because of the tank rewards, every single of you can take this vehicle for yourself and you can do many, many, many things with this tank. For example, hide in the bush, and that's it. Anyways, you know me, I'm not a big fan of this kind of gameplay, but we'll see what we can craft with this vehicle. Let's play a couple of battles with this tank and let's check it out. How is it going to stand in the battlefield against other vehicles? What do you think? Please no Himmelsdorf, please no Enns, give me something open. Prokurovka, Kempinovka, something where I can wank in the bush and smile for 3 days straight, please. El Haluf, not the best sniper schnitzel map, but oh well, what can we do? What is the options? What we supposed to do over there? The thing is, boys and girls, I am pretty sure we can't go into the heavy line for obvious reasons, because we simply cannot afford that. Now we need to make a decision. Do we want to sit over there and do nothing, or do we want to go somewhere over there and try to maybe spot someone which is playing around this area or something? This is the question, boys and girls. I think I know what we are going to do. I think I know what we are going to do. So let's move somewhere over there, and if someone is going to spot the lower ground for us, fellas, we will be able to shoot. Now speaking about the gun, how good it is. 203 penetration for a tier 7, it's completely fine. The accuracy is also quite good. But if you are deciding to shoot the gold ammunition, you have a penetration of 237. High explosives is quite useless unless you are going to shoot Arthas, or you are going to shoot the Scorpion or something which do not have any armor whatsoever, right? So this is the thing, boys and girls. Anyways. Now, the biggest highlight, how this vehicle is relocating and what is your speed. Now, as you can see, your speed with this tank, boys and girls, is very, very far away from being excellent or for being amazing or for being epic. It's just not the case, but it will work to go to the nearest bush and to snipe from over there. Now, the blind shot over there, obviously I missed. Not a big deal, we are going to shoot over there now. I missed. Now we are going to try to shoot over there, because we have all time in the world of tanks, and that was a miss too. Quite unfortunate thing, but not much what we can do about this. Now we are going to try to shoot somewhere over there. And that's a miss too. It's completely fine, fellas. We are just checking the standard and the typical bushes where people is usually playing over there, right? That's how we can get a bit of use for ourselves. So as you can see, Pantera is getting spotted and we are immediately smacking him for 200. Now Scorpion 250 in the face, and this is how you are working with this tank. You are having a safe defense parameter and you are simply banging everyone which is getting spotted. Simple as this. It can't get more simple than that, boys and girls. And in this position over there, what we are going to do, we are going to wait until the comet or until the Sioux is going to make a tiny touch more pressure over there. As you can see, Progetto is sitting right there. I have a shot on him. Too bad I did not manage to punish him, but it doesn't matter. We have all time in the world of tanks. Meanwhile, there is a Super Hellcat which is going to roll a lot through the middle, and that will work just fine for us. We are pre-aiming quite well for this guy, and we are simply punishing him for crossing the middle of the field. This is it. This is the whole gameplay of this vehicle. So if you are that type of player which really likes to be next to the red line, if you like to snipe the vehicles without getting spotted yourself and you know all red line bushes in the game, this is the tank for you. This is the tank which you want to take and with which you want to play with. Here you go, fellas. All review in couple of seconds, right? Anyways, we are just starting. We still need to obviously finish this battle. And after that, when we will finish this battle, we want to go for another one. Because you will see the basic stuff, what we are doing with this vehicle. And in the same time, you can do literally the same things with any tank which is created for bushwhacking, right? Okay, Super Hellcat is running for his life, but once again, I really doubt he's going to be able to escape from here, and he is dead. Beautiful. We punished this guy, he's dead meat, although he managed to spot us. But it doesn't matter. By the way, this tank is very, very, very similar to the Scorpion. Scorpion and this tank, it's pretty much the brother from other mother. Both of them is pretty much the same, apart one very, very important thing. This tank have a full turret rotation and Scorpion doesn't. So this is the main difference. By the way, that was a beautiful blind shot and I made a mistake right here. So I deserve to take one for the team. But it's completely fine, relax, take it easy. What we are going to do ourselves, boys and girls, we are going to try to outspot the Scorpion which is sitting over there. That was such a beautiful blind shot from his side. So now, wait for it, wait for it, wait for it until the binos will start working. And binos is working, great. All we need to do, we need to wait until the Scorpion is going to try to blind fire once again. And if he is smart cookie, he is going to do that. And as you can see, he's absolutely doing this. 300 in the face, that's great. Can we punish him over there? He thinks he knows where I am. In reality, he doesn't. He have no bloody clue where I am, and he is dead. Aww. So close and so far away. One hit points warrior, but the highlight over there is very, very simple. He pretty much, I pretty much high rolled him twice. So I have no complaints and no regrets how this battle went for us, right? Okay, what do we want to do now? We are sitting on our 2000 damage, which is great for this bushwhacker in my opinion. And what do we want to do? We simply want to craft a better angle for this Centurion, which might go a bit more in front. And as you can see, he is playing over there. That's great. Okay, turn around slowly but surely and try to craft a good angle on the Centurion, which might play over there. As you can see, he's thinking about it and schnai in the face. Now we are running. Beautiful. That was a good play for us, fellas. We did everything properly right here. And all we need to do, we need to wait until the Centurion will get unspotted. That pretty much means we are not spotted too. And we can go literally into the same bush once again. But before that, we are going to check it out. Is he going to go for a blind shot? And as you can see, he did. So that explains a lot. Very, very good. It's okay, fellas. Even though we took one for the team, that's not a big deal whatsoever. Our team is winning the battle, so we can be quite calm and quite happy over there. Now, what is going to happen right here? If he's going to go too much up the Scorpion and this guy is going to start shitting on him, and plus on top of that, he is in the crossfire by the T69. So whenever T69 is starting to go on him, what we are doing, we are moving backwards and we are simply schnaying the ass. And we are wishing him to have a nice day. Here you go, fellas. How I would rate this battle? I would rate this battle solid banana out of 10. That was a good game in my opinion. I think we did everything properly to the certain level, right? Obviously, the stupid thing from my side was I took one for the team from the Scorpion with a blind shot. But once again, that Scorpion connected the blind shot. Congratulations, hip hip hooray, that was a good one, right? Other than that, everything is fine. Now, this is very, very important point to highlight and to show for you. Speed. Now look, boys and girls, our mission, if we want to get a bit more use over there, we need to go on top of the hill to bang everyone which is playing over there. And you will see where this vehicle is lacking, where this vehicle is kind of sucking a massive PP. This is the speed how you are going on top of the hill. And you know what is the worst thing of all this? The speed is pretty much very, very similar when you are going in the straight line. It's quite similar, and probably majority of you would agree with me. So here you go, fellas. 11 kilometers per hour going in the Al-Haluf. That's not a dream speed. This is not a dream tank overall to play with, at least when I'm trying to compare this with E25 or even with a Scorpion. Scorpion is so much quicker, and Scorpion can do so many more stuff over there. But if enemies are making some mistakes, if enemies are not playing very, very well, let's be real right here, we can make this tank work. If I can make this vehicle work, fellas, every single of you can do literally the same thing, maybe even better than I did, right? So, in this battle we have 2,700 damage and 100 assisting damage. Now the question is, how much of Mark of Excellence percentage have we lost? Because hit points changes hit the game. We was on the 98%, if I'm not mistaken, right? Let's check it out. I'm very curious. I think we dropped like 5% or so. Only 1% drop right there. Crazy. Crazy. Only 1% drop. Anyways, in this battle, we are second on the damage, which is a great score for this vehicle in El Halof. And we made 71,000 profits with a premium account. Without premium account, it would be 44,000 profits. So yeah, heads down. Without speaking about this vehicle and speaking about other tier 6 tanks, fellas, it is very, very simple. You are going to make more credits with a tier 7 tank than you are going to make with a tier 6 tank, right? And if you care, and if only one thing which you care is the credits, maybe this is the vehicle for you. And in the worst case scenario, if you really don't like the tank, you can always sell it for 1,300,000 credits, which is a quick cha-ching to buy that tier 10 or tier 9 tank. You are going to get those missing credits, right? Okay, what do we have here? The second battle, we have a very, very interesting situation. We have shit ton of the heavy tanks. We have pretty much no Artas, which is very, very nice. And only one light tank. That's interesting. This is interesting stuff, fellas. Okay, what is the plan? There is two bushwhacking positions in my opinion. Option number one is to play somewhere around this area. Option number two is to play in this area. And you know what? I swear to Banana Lord, I never ever played right here. So you know what? Let's try to use that double bush and let's try to take that position and let's play against the heavy tanks, okay? I am extremely, extremely curious how the battle will go for us and how well we can get use of that position over there, okay? I am super duper hyper turbo interested in that. So let's do this. Let's make this position work, boys and girls. Obviously, what we want to do, we want to cross through the bridge, even though it's not the safest option, but it doesn't really matter, because we have a meatball in front, and his camo is shitter than our camo. If he's going to get spotted, it doesn't mean we are going to get spotted, and that's just great stuff for us, right? Now, I could stop in this bush over there just to try to spot the enemy forces right there. And as you can see, we are spotting the meatball, which is crossing like this. That's just great. Okay, let's wait until this meatball will try to go in. If he will try to go in, obviously we will be able to see him and we will be able to penetrate him. I hope so. That was a poor shot by me, but I deserved it. And as you can see, IS3 is playing over there. Okay, that's great. Good to know. Boys and girls, now this is the very first time when I am playing in this position over there, okay? I never ever played here. I don't know how is it going to work. Is it going to go well or is it going to go bad? So let's try to check it out. Let's try to check it out. The question is, can they actually spot us over there? I'm trying to punish him into the lower plate. And as you can see, we managed to do that. So that was a great stuff. How about this Oni which is crossing? We managed to punish this Oni and he snapshotted us. That wasn't the thing which I really wanted to see or which I wanted to experience. But oh well, it happens. Sometimes I need to take one for the team too, right? It's okay. That's not okay. You see this Tiger P? This Tiger P was spotted and this Oni tried to shoot that Tiger P. And instead of hitting this Tiger P, he hit me. That's unfortunate, but sometimes it happens, right? But once again, that's what I deserved. Because I was greedy bastard in a way over there. Now the question is, can we punish this Mr. Oni over there, boys? What do you think? Can we punish him or we can't punish him? This is the question. Actually, his friend is over there trying to punish him into his boob, but unfortunately we did not manage to do so. Okay, I'm not a big fan of this position. I don't even know what I'm doing wrong, but probably I assume I am not using the bushes very, very correctly right there, right? Since I'm not using the double bush, enemies can spot me, and if enemies can spot me, that's not very good. And once again, sometimes the allies can be the bigger problem compared to the enemies, right? As you can see, because if enemies are getting spotted, which is behind me, I am going to take one for the team, which is quite sad part. But oh well, it is how it is. Our team is losing this battle because they still have Onis over there and they still have many, many guys. But we have a MiG-65T, which is entering the battle and he's saying me. Okay, I missed an ideal shot into the Oni, but I can't change it over there. I am just accepting that and I'm saying "Ree," but silently, okay? I am crying only silently. And now how about this mother trucker which is sitting over there? Schnei. Beautiful. One Oni took one for the team. That's great. Slowly but surely, little by little, step by step. That's what we want to do. Now this guy have no bloody clue I'm over there and I want to hit him into his boob over there and obviously I missed. You know what is the funnest part of all this, boys and girls? In the first video, in the first part of this video, in the first battle, I was hitting everything, everything to the left, everything to the right, just kaboom, 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 kaboom. And right here, I am missing majority of my shots. But probably it is because in this battle, I'm not so lucky, right? Anyways, what do we want to do? You see this Hellcat over there? Oh, yes, this Hellcat over there. I'm trying to shoot him with the high explosives. Luckily, I managed to hit that. And we are still sitting over there and pretty much waiting until someone is going to make one or another mistake, right? Now the question is, can we find the shot into Excalibur? I really doubt we can, but what we could do, we could try to get the shot into this IS-22, right? That would be great stuff for us boys and girls, that would be amazing. But obviously the most debatable thing is this guy going to make a mistake right here? Is he going to try to peek or not really? Now, fellas, little by little, step by step, I will peer into the bush and I will simply wait until this IS-22 is going to peek sideways, right, like this, if he is going to do that. If he is not going to do that, then it is going to be quite a bit of problem. That was a pathetic shot from my side, to be fair with you, and currently I'm trying to run away. What is happening? As you can see, Super Hellcat Tiger PT-34, they are making a pressure like this. What is my hope? My hope is to get into the bushes over there so I can be as annoying as I physically and possibly can, right? That would be my main goal. And over there, we are kind of losing this battle too. But it's okay, this is a bushwanker life, fellas. Not every single time you can be the hero of the day. It's just how it goes, and this is World of Tanks, boys and girls. So what we are doing, we are going like this. Unfortunately, our Su-100 is taking one for the team, and Hellcat is down to 300 hit points. If I'm going to be lucky, I'm going to roll high. As you can see, we have 295 damage and 44 penetration. We could potentially roll high and kill him, but everything is depending on the luck over there, okay? This is how everything is looking like. So I'm trying to get just tiny touch closer over there. And as you can see, we need to craft the angle. Before everything, I want to load the standard ammunition because this Tiger P can die very, very easily. As you can see, he's over there, and as you can see, he's dead. Beautiful. That was excellent thing for us. How about the Super Hellcat now? Actually, before I will kill the Super Hellcat, how about Hellcat is going super aggressively and he's dead. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful Russia. Ooh, nice. Okay, what situation do we have? We need to defend against the mother truckers, which is going super aggressively like this. But once again, we have all time in the World of Tanks, so all we need to do, we need to wait until they will mess up, right? This is a perfect shot, obviously. When I said this is a perfect shot, we did not manage to penetrate him, and our Jackson needs to go back. Unfortunately, Jackson did not went back, so he got slaughtered. That's quite a bad thing. And now, most important thing, kill Borat. Whenever Borat will die, then we can try to get some more use right here, right? Borat is going super aggressively. Borat is dead. Beautiful. How about this Oni over there? Beautiful. Can we get one more? No, we can't. No, we can't. He was using bushes in front. Damn it. I smelled Kiri potential over there. I was smelling a victory, okay? That was a great game. I am feeling happy with all this battle, and here you go. This is alternative option how you can play with this vehicle. Even though if I would have more hit points right here, I really doubt we would win this battle. But that was a good go, fellas. You can say whatever you want. So we got 2,600 damage. We have 4 kills, which is very, very good thing. And we are second by the damage and second by experience. So this is making me extremely happy considering this game. Speaking about the profits, we spammed quite some APCRs, but we managed to make quite some profits anyways. But I have a feeling I have in-depth quite some APCRs left from some kind of other tank. So fellas, I would not make that much profit as I made over there because I did not pay it for gold and I fired quite some rounds. So probably profits would be like 30,000 tops. So keep this in mind, boys and girls. Anyways, with this tank, we managed to get 2,600 damage and 300 assistance damage, which is an extremely, extremely, extremely great score in my opinion, and I think I showed everything what you can do with this vehicle in amount of the time which we had, so for 2 battles, right? Anyways, boys and girls, leave your comment down below what do you think about this vehicle, and obviously thank you so much for watching as usual, thank you so much for your good words, your support, and for your hearts. Thank you so much for watching, see you next time, skill is out. Peace.